Pilot, Drain Man here, and today I have got a very special video. In today's video, we are going to be checking out the all-new HDLRC KT20 Pusher. KT, you might ask, stands for go-kart. This is a go-kart style indoor-outdoor FPV racing drone. You're not going to want to miss this. Let's go. All right, pilots, I am excited. Let's go ahead and crack this puppy open. But real quick, before I do, they did ship this with it. And I'm excited to see what it is. So, oh, Jesus. Okay. Look at that. That is a cool helicopter landing pad. This is very nice. But anyways, we are here for the indoor outdoor go-kart racing drone. Now this is super super awesome. I can't wait to show this to you. You guys are going to be like, what? Alright, so we crack the box open and inside you get some propellers. You get your foam. We'll notice that around the edge you have some bumper action going on here. This is for, you know, a safe place to bounce, but you also get an additional color. So that came with blue. I also have yellow. I'm sure you'll pick the color that works for you. You get adhesive, which you'll use to stick it on if you decide to change the color. You get the instructions, a little bit of miscellaneous screws. So also inside of the box, you're getting yourself a screw and nut. This is a nylon locking nut, and what that's for is right here on the front of the quadcopter. Is a great place to mount your naked GoPro, your Insta360 Go 2, whatever you're into, you can mount it right there, and that is the screw and nut that is a correct length to make that work. Now, inside of the bag, you are also getting a couple sets of the Avan E-Max four-bladed props in a clear color. It's like a smoked clear. Let's dive into why we are here today. Look at that, huh? That is original, huh? That is really cool. So you're actually landing on these little grooves right here. So that's pretty cool, huh? I like this, man. This is cool looking. I can't wait to see this thing fly, feel it fly, see what it looks like, see what it flies like. Look at this. So on the bottom, you've got like a little belly pad where you could mount from the bottom and then hold your stack, or you can actually mount from the top like they did here. So look at that. Super nice. All right, something else that I want to point out is you'll notice that the way our battery strap is going front to back. So that lets me know that this is going to hold my battery in a toilet bowl configuration. This is a 4S quadcopter, so you can rock anything from a 550 all the way up to an 850. This is a go-kart style racing drone, so I can bump and crash and fall and land. I mean, look at this. Everything is safe all the way around. No matter which way you do it, this is going to be a strong, durable drone that you can just have fun, bounce off the walls, chase the cat. So in the back here, we've got a little harness that holds our receiver. Look at that. Man, this is really nice. So back here, you've got a little pocket where your receiver will go. You run your wires up over to your stack, and then you can solder up and head over to your camera. And in the back, we've got an LED setup. And yes, these are addressable LEDs. So that's very cool because you can put them any color you'd like. You can match your bumper or don't, or set it up to do a Larson scanner, whatever you like. If you don't know how to set up LEDs on Betaflight, I've got a full video on how to do that. I will link that video for you down in the video description. Go ahead and check that out. All right, so for our camera, we have the Caddx Ant Eco camera. And that little guy is tucked up in there. It looks to me, once this cap is off, look at that, fully protected, okay? Which is great. That means I can take hits, I can bounce off walls, doesn't matter, I'm protected. All right, as far as our motors go, These are the Alias 1303.5 4500 kV motors. So when you're running this size stator and you're at 4500 kV, you're gonna wanna run a 4S. You can do 3, but I would recommend a 4 because you wanna have that punch that you need. It's a little hard to see because the motors are inverted, but I do absolutely love when they do that. But it is hard to see, but these motors are really sick looking. They are a two-tone with a teal. And I can see that in person, but they are really cool brushless motors. And you don't have to worry about your motor screws getting damaged because they're not on the bottom. That's not what you're, you know, landing on every time you're coming in. They're up top, they're protected. Turtle moding, I mean, is gonna be like, nothing. So this is great. This is really, really great. All right, so moving right along, inside, under the hood, right there in the heart of the drone, inverted, you are running the Zeus 10. This is a 2 to 6S flight controller, with an onboard 5-volt BEC. This thing is pretty sweet. It's got the MPU 6000 and it runs the Zeus F4 Evo firmware. So this is a great flight control. It's about 45 bucks and you can get any go-kart, Whoop, Micro, Nano, any type of guy like that up in the air. So if you've got your own custom build you're doing, or maybe you're gonna purchase the go-kart frame, this is the perfect stack to put in there. It's a Zeus 10 one board, diamond board. It does mount 25 by 25 and a half, and you put that guy in there and you're off to the clouds. Now our VTX, which is stacked on top, see that? It's kind of hard to see, but it's self-mounted on top right there. And that is the Zeus Nano 350 milliwatt VTX, and it is a very versatile VTX when it comes to mounting because it is so small and it's got 1, 2, 3 different hole sets. If you wanted, you could just put some double side sticky tape and stick that thing anywhere. Heading down the back is our receiver. Now this part is very, very changeable because you can buy this PNP, you can buy this BNF, which is bind and fly. That means you're getting a receiver like this has here. And what we've got on board with the analog one that shipped to me is the XM Plus for FR Sky. That is a great little guy. You're not gonna get crazy range, but it's perfect for around the house, around the yard, whatever you got going on. You got a little shoot coming up. All right, and then our antenna is the Hammer by HGLRC. This is a great little durable antenna. It does come SMA, MMCX, UFL. This is the it even comes in a stubby version if you wanted, but for this guy we needed to get it from the VTX out the back, so they went with a UFL connection and then zip tied it real nice and neat through this little channel, which is great for running stuff to the back, and you've got one to get to the front, which is really cool. And they went ahead and just stuck it through this little hole right here. I mean, I don't even think, yeah, one little zip tie and you're good. So that's a cool little compartment where you can fit all kinds of stuff. Now, these are chainable if you decide to purchase these HGLRC LEDs. They're super bright, super awesome, and chainable. So you can daisy chain by plugging the next one in here, and you could even maybe hide your wires behind there. Boom, get one there. Go again. Boom, get one here. You know, whatever you want. Before you purchase your packs for this guy, keep in mind it is XT30, and they gave you a nice little cap right on the plug for you, so you don't have to worry about that. All right, let's go ahead and power this up and see what she sounds like. Whoo! Oh, yeah. Oh, we got the Larson Scanner Purple. Dude, this is gonna be sick. And then inside, you can see everything's looking great, working great. This is gonna be awesome. All right, pilot, so that is gonna do it for our overview. I'm gonna go ahead and charge up this pack. I'm gonna bind this receiver and I'm going out to the field. Stay tuned for the flight footage. I hope that you guys are as excited as I am. I hope that you guys will get your own go-kart racing drone. And I hope that you enjoyed this video. I will see you on the next one.